I needed to make money fast, quick, and get my degree and get in and out as quick as possible. It is your girl Carly Ray coming at you guys with another nursing video. So you guys, I know I've been gone for a minute, but that's neither here nor there. If you are a OG subscriber of mine, you guys already know why I was gone. For those of you who do not know, it's because I'm on my 7-day stretch. If anytime you guys see me missing in action on social media, on YouTube, whatever the case may be, it's because I'm on my 7-day working stretch. And right now in the emergency room, we are in flu season, so it is like super jam-packed. It's crazy. It's balls to the wall all day long. So if anytime you guys see me missing in action, it's because I'm on my 7-day working stretch. But so today's nursing video kind of came to me on a whim. I honestly was up at 5 o'clock in the morning just randomly scrolling through my social media, and it just dawned on me that I needed to talk about this topic. So by the title, you guys already know what this video is about to be about. It is about ADN nursing and is it the best route for you? So let me go ahead and give you guys a background for those of you who are new to my channel. Hi girl, welcome, welcome, welcome. And if you have not subscribed yet, then I will give you this moment to go ahead and subscribe. Okay, so for those of you who do not know, like I just said, I'm coming up on my 8th year of nursing. My specialty is in the emergency room, and I have been there for the last 8 years. I've done travel nurse. I've been a charge nurse several times at different facilities. I've precepted nurses and things like that, and I've done all of this with my ADN. So the reason why I wanted to make this video is because I ran across a young lady that pretty much was telling me that her friends who were in the BSN program were kind of second guessing her decision as to why she chose the ADN route. So for those of you who do not know too much about the ADN or ASN, which is newly what it's called now, ADN and ASN means the same thing. But yeah, so for those of you who do not know too much about the ADN route, I am here for you. I am your advocate. I am your liaison. So let's go ahead and get into the benefits of being an ADN nurse. Number one, y'all already know about my coins, honey. It is way cheaper than going the BSN route. So I have a lot of friends that I work with currently, and they are still in $20,000, $30,000 worth of debt to obtain a similar degree to mine. We both sat down and took the NCLEX together, and we both passed the NCLEX and everything, but the only difference is that I came out cheaper than them. So when I graduated nursing school, I graduated with about, I say roughly around $17,000 to $18,000 in student loan debt. Y'all, honestly, that may sound like a shocker, but it's really not a shocker. So each year that I was there at my junior college where I got my associate's degree of nursing, each year I took out the maximum amount of money, and I took out the maximum amount because I wasn't working at the moment. My mom was a single mom, and it was just me and her, and we needed that type of income to help support me throughout school. So I always took out the maximum amount of loans that I could. Now, I didn't take out those loans where they charge you interest while you're in school, because at that moment, at that time, I didn't have money, so I didn't need anybody charging me money on money that I'm borrowing from them, knowing that I don't have money. So I just thought that was kind of stupid and crazy of me to do, but nonetheless, I took out the maximum amount of loan. So like I said, I graduated with about $17,000 to $18,000 in student loan debt. Now I will tell you, my repayment of those loans started 6 months after I graduated, and it's only about $150 a month for my student loans, which is very, very doable, and it's very, very easy. Now don't get me wrong, at times I have took $600, $700 and just paid off, you know, a good portion of my student loans. Yes, I have done that whenever I was able to actually put up a lot of money towards my student loans. So currently right now, I have about $6,000 left in student loan debt. Y'all, I'm so excited about that. Now, don't get me wrong, I could go ahead and probably wipe out my student loans, but then again, it's only $150 a month, and it's also a good benefit for me because it's a second line of credit. So I am really comfortable right now with my student loans. And now my other coworker, on the other hand, she still got about a good $20,000-$30,000 in student loan debt. So that was one huge benefit as to why I chose my ADN/ASN route. Another benefit of me doing ADN route was it allowed me to actually get out of school quicker. So with me being able to get out of school quicker, I was able to get to the field and gain as much experience as I possibly could. So whereas the BSN had 4 years of nursing school, I had the 2 years of the nursing program, and by the time that they actually graduated, I had already had maybe about a year or two experience. So I was able to actually branch off, do other things, move up within the company if I wanted to, you know, things like that. So it allowed me to get in and out of school and directly straight to the money. Because I mean, I'm gonna say it for y'all again, at this time, all I had was me and my mom, and we really just did not have a lot of money. So I needed to make money fast, quick, and get my degree and get in and out as quick as possible. So this next benefit is gonna step on some toes depending where you are located geographically. I am within East Texas area, and I can tell you firsthand, in the East Texas area, let me say that one more time, in the East Texas area, there is no pay difference in between the BSN and the ADN. So with the BSN, they may get paid upwards to no more than a dollar or two, but that's the max amount of money that you would get paid differently than a ADN. Now, you guys will do the same exact job, y'all will work side by side and things like that. So I didn't really see it as a huge benefit for me to go back to get my BSN whenever I knew that once I obtained my BSN, I would go back to doing the exact same job. The only difference is that I would make maybe $1 or two more, but I spent like $8,000-$10,000 just to obtain some different letters behind my name. So that is why I say it is very, very, very important that you go out and scout within your area. See if the local hospitals hire ADNs and see if they hire BSNs. If your area is only hiring BSN nurses, then sis, go get your BSN. But if your area allows ADN and BSN, and you know that, hey, you gotta get to the money quick and you gotta go the cheapest route, then why not go ahead and go for the ADN route? You can always go back later. So that was one huge benefit for me, is because I knew that my area was still hiring ADN nurses and there wasn't like a big difference in between the two. So this topic once again will step on some toes. So within my area, once again, the East Texas area, the pay isn't different at all. And I'm trying to make it another point to you guys. So for example, the facility that I work at right now, the BSN and the ADN nurses make the same. But guess who paid more for school? The BSN. But you're making the same as the ADN, who paid a lesser amount of money to go to school. So I would also, if I were you, do your homework, sis. See if they hire ADNs within your area. If they do, then great, thumbs up. And if the pay is a huge difference, then maybe if you want more pay, go for your BSN. If that's your area. But if your area is anything like mine, where there's really not a huge pay difference in between the ADN and BSN, then I don't see why not to go for the ADN route. Another benefit is the opportunities that I have been presented with my ADN degree. I have been able to travel to these so-called magnet status hospitals that only have BSN nurses. But let me tell you one thing about hospitals. If they are in a critical, dire need for nurses, and they are having to use the help of travel agencies to bring nurses into their facility, I can guarantee you they're gonna allow an ADN nurse. So I don't want you guys to kind of get hung up on that. So I was still able to travel and do things. I traveled to several different places within Texas. I've even done stripe nursing all the way up in Minnesota. It's just different things that I've been able to do. I've been able to be a charge nurse. I've been able to precept people, think, all of that. I've been able to do all of that, all with my ADN degree. So I don't want you guys to think that just because you go for your ADN degree that you won't be able to level up, so to speak. Yes, you will, sis. Yes, you will be able to travel. Yes, you'll still be able to go do stripe nursing and all those other fun things. Yes, you'll still be able to move up to that trauma nurse if you want to. Yes, you'll still be able to move up to charge nurse if you want to. And if you're hardworking and dedicated to it, then those opportunities are still available. So do not doubt yourself. Another benefit is this. Say that you are working for a hospital that is deciding to become magnet status and have a large percent of their nurses be BSN, then guess what? Your hospital may offer for tuition reimbursement. And so what that means is that they will pay for you to go to school. Each facility will be different on how their tuition reimbursement works. I know for my facility, they were telling us that, hey, you go ahead, sign up for your classes, pay for them. If you pass the class with a C or higher, they will reimburse you that money. But a lot of times that will come with a contract. I'm not going to go into that topic right there because that's a whole nother can of worms. But yeah, so just make sure you read the fine print about the tuition reimbursement. If you are fine with that fine print that's in that tuition reimbursement program, then go ahead and do it. So I don't want you guys to ever think that, oh, well, I'll probably have to pay money later on down the line. No, there are hospitals that will actually pay for you to go back to school to get your BSN degree. So this, once again, you can come out cheaper just by doing that. Now, some of the downfalls within having your ADN/ASN degree is if your area is conducive to BSN nursing and you're ADN, you will have limited type of opportunities, meaning that a lot of hospitals won't hire you. You may be just kind of shunned to like a nursing home or a LTAC, or which just means like a long-term care facility and things like that. So if that's the case, sis, I would try to move it over into the next town and see what the next town is looking like. Now, don't get me wrong, you can be limited with your ADN, but if you live within that area that's not conducive to an ADN, then don't go for ADN. You get what I'm saying? Although it is the fastest and cheapest route out there, don't go for it if your area is not hiring ADN. Another downfall is that, say, like me, I'm 8 years in and I decide to go for my nurse practitioner's degree. Well, now I have to look at getting my BSN. And so that's another step that I would have to take. Whereas my friends that graduated already with their BSNs, they just have to transition from BSN to FNP. Family nurse practitioner. So with me, I would have to spend another year getting my BSN degree, A, more money, and then for two, I would have to get my FNP degree, which would be extra money as well. So, you know, it's pros and cons to it, but I know for me, at one time I did think about getting my family nurse practitioner's degree, but I have done my homework and looked within this area and talked to several of my coworkers that was going through the FNP program. There are not a lot of opportunities in this area for F&Ps. They're very, very slim. And so with the opportunities here for F&Ps being very slim, then guess what that means? So that means that the person that is trying to employ one of the F&Ps, they will offer them a lower amount of money yearly. So with me, I just feel like I'm not about to take a pay cut whenever I'm spending $20,000 to $30,000 to get this degree. I don't think that's very smart for me. I don't think that's financially right for me to do either, because I know one thing for sure is that I have to stay within this area. My family's here, my children are here, my husband's here, my house is here. I can't leave this area. And a lot of my friends that are in their F&P program, they are having to outsource to like West Texas, which is like 9 hours away, and uproot their whole entire type of life, you know? And I just don't want that. I don't see that for myself. But that is it for this video, guys. I hope this video was very helpful and informative for you guys. I'm really just trying to reach those of you out there who are considering the ADN route or the ASN route. Please, 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 my biggest thing that I could tell you, please, please, please look within your area to see if they are hiring ADNs. So if they are, then sis, you got the green light, go for it, sis, go for it. But unfortunately, if your area does not hire that many ADNs and you have very, very limited opportunities with the ADN, I would say do not go for it at all. Do not. The area in which I live in hires a lot of ADN nurses, and I have a lot of opportunities that I have been presented within this 8 years of nursing. So that is it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please do not forget to subscribe. You guys can share this video with fellow other nursing students, any pre-nursing students, anybody thinking about nursing, your mama may be thinking about nursing. Share the video, because I really want this information to get out into the right hands and get in front of the right people. So that is it, guys, and I will see you guys in my next videos. Bye.